fact that you all are here shows that yes, stress is present somewhere, and definitely we are looking out to counter it. Now, my dear friends, we read so many books, you know, we go through so many management skills, so many workshops, conferences, talk shows, etc. Let me tell you one thing, everybody and everything is right in their own ways, somewhere or the other. And looking at the stress which is growing day by day, in and out, you know, every day we are encountering more and more stress. As the world is moving ahead, getting it more modernized, more and more stress is coming up. So what basically we need to do is, we need to upgrade ourselves, update ourselves how to encounter. Now when we speak about encountering stress is like, okay, fine. A stress has come, I encounter stress. That means when I use the word encounter, it means I'm going to fight stress. So, if I'm going to fight stress, what is going to happen is, the stress is bound to come back to me at some point of time or the other. Maybe after a week, maybe a month, maybe a year, or maybe a few days. We do not know about it. But yes, it's bound to come back. So as I said, we need to update ourselves every time, every moment of life. So the concept is now convert stress to energy the holistic way. Now before I begin, I would like to have your introduction. Please tell me about yourself, your name and what you're doing, so that we have an understanding what kind of background you're having in terms of work profile or whatever, and the level of stress can be ascertained. I've got something to give you a little later, of course. So when you walk out today from here, I would like, you know, stress-free and smiling and happy. Thank you. And I give you my word, all of you will walk from here smiling. Thank you. So let's begin, sir. You're in. Okay. Fine. Thank you, sir. Yes, sir.
I'm MD Mandivara. I was a businessman. I'm present to attend.
Thank you. Yes, sir.
Myself, Dr. Srivastava. I'm MD.
Thank you.
Yes, I'm Lisa Golanda. I'm HRD professional. I have a doctorate study.
Welcome. Yes, sir.
Moving on in water, power generator business, and hiring business.
Okay. That's nice. Yes, sir.
Francis Kavala, insurance.
Thank you, sir.
Sanjay Madam.
Thank you. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Wow, that's nice. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you. Thank you again.
Hello. Yeah. Sir, my name is Alvin Disoda. I'm working as an operator.
Okay. Welcome. Yes, sir. Welcome, sir. Thank you, and please clap for yourself. You know, it is good to clap for yourself rather than to clap for someone else. It's a fact of life. You know, this is the beginning. It is actually the beginning. Whenever we go for any kind of you know, programs or whatever, we have some shows or whatever, VIPs come, the guests come, this one comes, and we all are clapping for them. At some point, my dear friends, somewhere in our heart, we feel, why does somebody not clap for me? I'm doing so much work at home. I move in the morning, whole day I'm working. The lady is working at home, or she's maybe a working woman, whatever. The man is also working. They all are working for the family, and there is nowhere a clap for that person. So somewhere the built-up begins. The build-up begins. It begins subconsciously, somewhere at the back of the mind. Let me tell you, assure you one thing, I'm not going to use any kind of high funda words where you and I don't understand what we are talking. We'll keep it very simple at the base level. So somewhere at the back of the mind, we keep on, you know, it starts accumulating. I did this today, I bought a gift for my child and my child did not even say thank you. He or she did not even get me a glass of water. He or she did not even give me a smile, forget a thank you. The build-up begins somewhere at the back of the head. Now, my dear friends, it is like convert stress to energy the holistic way. Now, if we don't understand certain things, it'll be useless for me to talk to you through the evening today. When we say stress, now you tell me, what is stress? What do you understand by stress?
You are feeling uncomfortable.
Okay, feeling uncomfortable. And what else? I mean, whatever you feel, what is stress? See, all of us have a different definition and all is correct. Nothing is wrong. So let's have a discussion
conflict.
Here.
Conflict,
fine.
Fear, lot of fear.
Fear, very good. And? Yes,
anxiety.
Sir. Anxiety, very good.
Built up
tension.
Tension,
okay, very good.
Built up tiredness.
Built up tiredness. Yes, sir.
No happiness.
No happiness. Also stress. Yes, sir.
Difficulty
in coping up with the situation. Very good. Anything else?
Striving for business.
Striving for business. Fine. In all this, what did we notice? It is unhappiness, it is tiredness, it is something not happening. So in all this, let us understand one thing. Stress is nothing but energy. It is nothing. Stress is nothing but energy. It is simple energy. I'm telling you, it is very, very simple energy. Nothing more than energy. If this is an energy, why is it harming us? Why do we feel like fighting with it? Or why do we feel like running away from it? Why?
Because it is not favorable to us.
Because it is not favorable for us. Now, it's a very good answer. Because it is not favorable for us. We know cooking, right? Most of us, something or the other, some point we must have done something, right? We use the knife. We use the knife to
cut
what?
Vegetables.
And?
Onion, fruits.
Favorable or unfavorable?
Both.
Favorable. So let's talk about knife being unfavorable now.
Yes.
Killing, murder, threatening. Yes? Very nice. Cutting vegetables which I don't like, so unfavorable. So we saw one knife having being favorable and being unfavorable. Same way, stress is an energy, favorable and unfavorable. Now let us understand how this stress becomes unfavorable. How many of us in this room have driven car? Okay, we have driven car. Okay, how many of us have sat in the car? Not driven or sat driven, whatever. Fine, all of us. Either we have sat in the car or we have driven a car. Now let us go like this. We sit in the car, we start the car is moving. At speed 20, how do you feel? Chill, relax, you're not even bothered the car is moving. Confident, the car is in complete control. It goes 30, 40, say 40 speed, you are a little upright, you're looking, but still you're okay, relax. You can control the car. You can control the car. Anything happens, red signal comes, a child runs, you can stop the car immediately. The car is going at 60 now. Now depends where you're driving, you are definitely alert. Your full attention is on the road. 60. You go 80, then you don't know what's happening. 80, 90, 100, you are not sure whether you are controlling the car or the car is controlling you. At that point of time, you have two choices. Be very brave and continue, or be smart enough and come down on your speed. If you continue with the speed, what will happen? You may crash. The car may go out of control. If you come down the speed, you are in control of your car. Stress is the same thing, my dear friends. It is the same energy. The moment you get stress, first, we are very comfortable. That's what we call it, and it is known as good stress. You know, once upon a time, I used to wonder, what is this good stress? How can stress be good? How can stress be good? Stress cannot be good until one fine day I understood that stress is nothing but energy. So this is good energy. So when our stress is good, we are working with it, we are okay with it. When the stress starts building up, we overlook it. And when it goes beyond our control, what happens to us? What happens to us? So crash means what happens? Like what? In the hospital, we are sick. We may have, like, you know, we hurt ourselves, anything. Because we are not paying attention, we may not perform well in our studies, we may not perform well at work, we will not perform well as parents, we will not perform as a good member of the community or the society, whatever. So first, did we understand the correlation between your car and the stress? Yes or no?
Yes.
Please answer me. If you don't answer, then I have to be there.
Yes.
Only if you understand, I move it.
Yes.
Now, next we come to energy. We finish with stress. Don't worry, it's just beginning. Finish means just the word. Now we come to energy. Now we stated something that stress is
energy.
Energy. What is energy now? If you don't understand 1, 2 and 3, that's pointless me standing here and you sitting here. Then we are doing time pass, which we don't want. Then what is energy? Okay, now.
Power to work.
Boosting, okay. Power, yes.
Strength.
Strength.
Force.
Okay. Force, okay. And what?
Stimulation.
Stimulation, very good. What comes to your mind is important for me now. What do you mean by energy?
Something positive.
Something? Positive.
Positive,
okay. And? Sorry?
Capacity to work.
Very good. What else can we?
Achievement.
Put you favoring to achieve your goal.
Put it favoring to achieve your goal. Very good. And what else, sir? What crosses your mind? Energy, for me, okay, if you say energy, it might be some energy drink. It could be anything. What crosses your mind is important?
Positive vibration.
Positive vibration. Very good. Yes, sir?
Fuel that drives you.
Fuel that drives you. Very good. Very nice. Now, energy is being, B-E-I-N-G, being, and in that being, it can contain almost anything. It could be solid, it could be liquid, it could be gaseous, any form. Like for example, we have energy drink, we drink and we get energy, it's a booster, it's in the liquid form, it goes, it gives us energy. So energy is being. Means it is there, something is there. Now we have not checked out in what form it is there. Because now we are talking about stress, energy and holistic, about our body, about ourselves. Right? Yes or no?
Yes.
Thank you. I need to hear you. So we understand energy now?
Yes.
Energy is being. What is holistic then? Very interesting. What is holistic? I'm not going to speak now. I'm only going to listen. You please speak, all of you. Give me your answers. I'm listening. Whatever you feel is holistic, tell me what is holistic.
Mental, physical, emotional, spiritual well-being.
Okay. Ourself, divine, positive self, yes.
Positively favorable.
Sorry? Man as a whole, very good. A complete being. Yes, what else? Positive forces, very good. And what else? What else do you think about it? What else do you think about holistic is? What do you think is the meaning of holistic?
Natural, organic.
Natural, organic. Fine. Holistic, my dear friends, is divine. Very good. All the answers that I got is all correct. Perfectly good. In my words, I would say something that is not made by man, chemicals especially, is not holistic. Remaining everything is holistic. Minus the man-made chemicals, right? Everything is holistic. Everything is holistic. Because when we say about holistic, as you said, divine, your whole self, mind, body, soul, everything coming in one line, everything is correct. Everything is perfectly good, perfectly correct. a little technically, something that is not made by man is holistic. Man-made chemicals are not holistic. So remaining everything is holistic. Now let us see how can we convert stress to energy the holistic way. Now tell me the holistic ways. What do you think according to you is a holistic way? Give an example.
Not harmful to others.
Fine. Tell me a way now. Zariya. Zariya, correct? I'll give an example. The most simple example I'll tell you is yoga is a holistic way. Now you give me examples.
Meditation.
Okay. And?
Prayer.
There are many, many. I want to hear at least 40, 50 from you now. Come on. Because we have to go smiling from here. Otherwise, I'll be staying here tonight.
Yes, sir.
Sorry, sir.
To be in tune with nature.
Very good.
Exercise.
Okay. What else?
Sleeping.
Dreaming. Very good.
Talking.
And very good. Come on. Fire.
Music.
It's a fire round.
Music, painting.
Very good. Swimming. Learning. Very good.
Walking.
Sorry, sir.
Entertaining.
Very good. Entertaining. Yes, sir. Let's have one from you. Whatever gives you pleasure. Very good. That is also healing in a holistic way. Very good.
Music.
What else, sir? Yes, tell me. If give me good answers, I'll give you something right now in 2 minutes. In. Yes, I'm actually waiting to give you.
Something that is positive.
Something that is positive. Very good. Yes, deep to your soul, which really sparking, which gives you a spark outside. Now, my dear friends,
breathing exercises,
very good. Now, since you know all the terms here, we can move ahead. Now, since we decided what is holistic, we understood what is holistic and we understood what is stress. Now, what are we doing? We are converting. What are we doing? We are converting stress to energy the holistic way, the natural way. So what happens when you convert some energy in whatever form, forget it, whether it's holistic or non-holistic, what will you use it for?
Depends.
Correct. Very good. It will depend what you want to use it for. The reason I asked you this question in the beginning is because once we start going through it, you will know where to use this in your life. How to use it in your life, you know where to use it. Now in my life, I'll use it somewhere, you will use it somewhere. Some people will use it for health, some people will use it for finance, some people will use it for relationship, some people will use it for career, whatever. There will be thousands of reasons to use this energy. Now where to use is your ball game. How to use is my problem, to show you how to convert it. Are we ready for it?
Yes, sir.
Good students, thank you. Good friends rather, sorry. So shall we have some volunteer please? Thank you. Yeah, what we need to do is just pass one each to all of them. Now see, the class has already begun. Let me tell you one thing, the class has begun. Please take one and pass on. I'll pass on the sharpener as well. Oh, you can use, if you all are having the pen, you can use a pen. You want the pencil, use the pencil, whatever you feel good. Yeah, thank you so much, sorry. Yes, exactly. It is not sharpened because it is a part of
action.
Yeah, it's a part of learning here. Stress to energy. Yeah, I've got sharpener. Please, those who need it, use it and please pass it on. Please do not go through the paper now. Keep the paper with you. Do not go through the paper. Please. I passed on a sharpener. It's not sharp. Now see, you've got to convert it to sharpness.
You wanted
exactly. You know, the best part is everything is a learning process. Now what happens here is, I could have easily got the pencil sharpened and give you all everything ready made. There's a reason why I didn't give, which I'll come to it later on, a little later from here. Yes. Fine. So you may go through the sharpening of the pencil. You can use your pen if you would like to use your pen. Definitely. Yes, we have to use the paper. You ready? No, don't start. I'll just come to it. Don't start. Just write your names behind so that you don't, you know, the paper is for you. You've got to take the paper home. I'll keep one with me. I'll explain what we need to do. Fine. Now, this is a self-stress test. Now, dear friends, there are many stress tests. I picked up, rather made a combination and made it a little general for us so that we know what we are doing and where we are standing today. Shall we begin?
Yes.
Fine. On the left side, it's don't mind leaving things temporarily unfinished, and immediately on the right side is must get things finished once started. Now how do I circle this? It is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. If you're sorry,
why not 10?
Why up to 7? Because I don't know to count beyond 7. Fine. So here what happens is, if anything on the left side I want to answer, I answer anywhere between 1 to 3. And if my answer is on the right side, I answer between 5 to 7. If you feel it is at a height, extreme, go to 7. If it is low, come down the number. If you feel between the two, put on number 4. If you don't understand any questions, please ask me. I will explain it. You may please start here. Yeah, I'll repeat it. See, there are two set of questions. One is on the left, one is on the right. You have to answer either the left one, the first one, for example. Don't mind leaving things temporarily unfinished. Next is, must get things finished at once. So where do I stand? I feel I must finish things. So I will mark somewhere between 5 to 7. Then I'll come to the second one. Calm and unhurried about appointments. Next is, never late for appointments. For me, 7. So I'll go. But please answer, let me tell you, I'm not going to see your paper. Nobody is going to see your paper. Please answer very honestly because the paper is with you. Nobody is going to check your paper. Please. So you want a paper? Fine. take your time, do not rush, because this is quite important. It's for you. If you don't understand, please do ask. I'll be happy to help you. Once you're done, total your score. Yeah. Yeah. Go through the numbers, total all the numbers, what you have circled or you have marked. Both.
All together.
Whether it's right or left, take all into consideration. The self-stress test, you need to mark. Thank you. Once we are done, please total up your score, and down you may write, wherever you want to write, you may write your total score. There's no need to share, definitely no need. It's very personal, so you can keep it for yourself. So are we done, most of us? Okay, now those who have done, let's share the scores. Just tell me the score. 89. 103, fine. Yes, sir? Okay, anyways, fine. 50. 59. Yes, ma'am?
64.
85. 83. 76. 107.
68.
62. What I understand is like fairly good crowd.
Average
and you know, real go-getters. No, y'all are already improved guys. Now I'm feeling that I need improvement. No. We don't want you to go to a higher level in this score sheet. We want you to come to a lower level. I think I should take some tips from you guys because my score is very pretty high.
Oh, good.
No, it's not so good. It shouldn't be that good. Fine. Now let us discuss, shall we?
Yes.
Fine. Now, what happens is when we see the score, anyone with 120 score plus, that's mine of course. Anyone else here? No one else. Anyways, let's understand that if the score is crossing 80 onwards to 120, that's a fairly big score and it is a high stress score. It is not happening.
What do you mean high stress score?
High stress means high built up energy. The energy which is built up is very high. It is more. The stress is more. Yeah, we are coming to that, sir. No problem. So what happens is when we have a high score, it indicates that we have a lot of built up inside us, which we may or may not be aware of. Only when we come and stand in front of the mirror do we understand how am I looking. Am I dressed well? Am I neat? Is my hair okay? Have I done my makeup okay or not? Until then, we feel we are fine. Then we go out in the world. We step out of the house. We move in the street. We go to the mall. We go to our office, whatever. And our friend or our colleague tells us, "Arey, your shirt is not ironed properly today. What happened? The pocket is not proper. Or maybe something is not okay. This little stain is there. You didn't see that. There's something, your hair is going little grey, you didn't do the touch up this time, your makeup, your lipstick is not proper." Now this happens because the opposite person is looking at us and commenting on us on the physical level. We are talking physical level, outside, what we can see. And we say, "Oh, I did not see in the mirror, or maybe I was rushing up, so I forgot, I overlooked it and I moved out. Thank you." Then we go in to the washroom, clear up ourselves, and we are back trying to be normal. Why am I speaking this? Because when our stress level goes high, our near and dear ones, our friends, our family members, our co-workers, our bosses, our colleagues, they start commenting, they start telling us things which we at times don't like it. For example, a child may tell the mother or the father, "Nowadays you don't have time for me. We were supposed to go for a movie, we didn't go. You were supposed to sit with me for homework, it's not done. Last week you promised me to bring a new toy, you didn't bring that." So on and so forth. A colleague may say, "What's this here? You used to bring one roti extra for me. Nowadays you don't bring." See, the colleague will not report immediately. After a point of time, after maybe 7, 8, 9 times, because the colleague starts or the friend starts feeling, "Arey, you used to do this good to me, now you don't do. You don't even look at me. You don't even say good morning to me nowadays." This is because our stress level has started building up and we are not aware of it. So it starts showing in our outward behavior in the society. And when this starts happening, people start looking at our behavior. After a point of time, they start commenting on our behavior. And when those comments starts coming in, maybe you will sit down and think, "What's wrong with me?" Now next thing comes in this part is communication. We talk to each other, yes or no?
Yes.
We make phone calls, we send mails, we do so many things through the day. So many people we talk to. we interact. How much time, like today, today what you have done, when you walked in, I said clap for yourself, thank you for coming here. Today what you have done, my dear friends, is you have invested time for yourself. And most of you do whenever you come to this place. It is an investment, not in your money, what you get out of it, but in your time. You are investing time for yourself, which will result into good well-being of your own self. So, what happens? We communicate, coming back to communication, we communicate with the whole world outside, the whole world. Friends, teachers, this, that, blah, blah, everyone, even on the strangers, we talk to strangers, somebody says, ha, ye address, ha, you go run and help the person, show him or her the address. You help the person to lift something, you help an old elderly citizen to cross the road, you help so many people. If somebody is hungry, you may give khana to eat. But how much time do you give yourself? How much time do you give yourself? How much time do you take to yourself to sit and talk to yourself? When you talk to yourself, my dear friends, what you are doing is you are analyzing your day-to-day routine and affair. There is a time and the place you will understand, oh, I am going somewhere off my track. And if I go for too long, I will have some problem. And this is what we do not do most of the time. And that is the reason stress builds up. What builds up is energy within us, within ourselves. Now you are asking me about what is a remedy. The whole class is a remedy. Now what we are going to talk about today is nothing but remedy till we move out of here. Now the best part is nobody, 80 to 90 is high stress. 60 to 80 is again a stress which cannot be and should not be neglected. 50, your score 50 to 60, your stress is in control. You can take care of it, you can come back. Which means it will not spoil your health. For 30 to 40, you're in good control of your stress. 20 to 30, you're relaxed. You're relaxed. You know, we feel when something happens and when we look at some important people in the government offices, we think, how can they be so relaxed? They don't care. No, my dear friends. They go for management classes like this. They go for de-stressing classes. They have to do that. They have to train themselves not to get attached with the problem, because they are attending to hundreds and thousands and lakhs of people around. Here we get stressed with one child at home telling us something. We get hurt. We get upset. My child said this. My child said that. My child did not do the homework and I'm getting stressed up. Who has not done? The child has not done. Who's stressing up? I'm stressing up. Who is going to fail in the exam? The child, not me. But I'm getting all the stress in the world. Why? Because Mrs. Malhotra will say, "Arey, your child failed. Arey, your child got less mark," or whatever. We are more worried about what somebody will say and we are building up our stress. So who's the culprit here, my dear friends?
We
are the culprit. Let's find out who's the culprit also, no? Since we are doing stress, let us find out who is the culprit here. I am the driver of the car, so I am the culprit. I am driving my body. I am being stressed up. I am bottling up all the energy. Now, let's say we take a soda. We open the soda bottle. Right? Now, you see fizz coming out?
Yes.
It is coming out constantly. Normally, nicely, it's coming out. You look at it sparkling. Bubbles coming out, enjoying it. You put your hand and you shake it. And don't leave it. What will happen? It wants to have a release. It may even blast. Everything has a capacity. Even balloon has a capacity. It'll grow big. And there is no space. It blasts. My dear friends, our body is exactly the same way. We fail to learn from our body. Our body is exactly ditto the same way. we are taking in the stress, we are building up energy, we forget stress, we are building up energy, we are building up energy, we are building up energy, and we are not using it, we are not letting go. In earlier days, all this is important for us to move ahead. In Purane Zamane mein, people used to work hard, yes or no?
Yes.
Used to work hard, farming, cutting trees, carpentry, this, that, whatever. Whatever they used to do, even children in school, if they had to calculate something and the child is not smart, he or she will take the pen, paper or chalk, something and scribble, scribble, scribble and get the answer. Application. Energy is utilized. Go out, run, play, push, everything, fall down, still they are not bothered, they are falling, they are running, pushing, doing everything. Energy is utilized every day. You know why? Every day? Because all of us, me, you, even the small baby who is newborn baby, we all produce energy every day. The question is, are we utilizing that energy every day? We are not. At least the modern man is not utilizing that energy every day. Olden days, fine, we used to run, jump, do this, run for the train, run for the bus. Now, most of us has a car, most of us has a bike, auto is there, taxi is there, whatever is there. We don't even want to walk the minimum distance somewhere. We still want to take the car or the bike, or friend is there, sit on the bike or car, whatever, and go. Finished. Energy unutilized leads to bottling up, leads to what? Stress? Stress?
Yes.
Want the remedies now?
Yes.
Very good. Fine. Now you tell me, may I rub the board?
Yes.
May I help you?
No. Thank you. No, I was just wondering, is it legal to rub the board or not?
Yes.
That's the reason I didn't touch the board since the time I've come. Now what's happening? Now we are talking about holistic way or more simpler, natural way. Now my dear friends, tell me, we discussed something, right? Cycling, running,
swimming,
walking. Now you will tell me, I don't have time for all this. Yes or no?
Yes.
Obviously, you will tell me there's no time.
No.
So,
no.
No time.
Time
is there. Very good, sir. I'm with you. Exactly. Very good. So now what are we doing here? Now, I'm going to put a few things on the board. I'm not going to show you one way of doing it, my dear friends. I will not show you. You do it like this and this will happen. No, I'm not here to do that. I'm not here to put you in a frame that I should do like this only. No, I will give you your way of converting stress to energy, not my way. I will show you how much time you are having, what are the powers you are having, holding within yourself, your capacity, your means, your time, your place, your space, your everything, and you are converting your stress to your energy. And then utilize the way you want it, not the way exactly the way I want to. So the more answer you give me, the better I will be able to help you out. Okay?
Yes.
So let's make it friendly.
Yes.
Two way. Fine. So let's say cycling. Don't worry, I'll give you something more from my end also, which you can. Let's have the outward one first, the general ones. Cycling, walking,
dancing.
Running,
interaction with your loved
one. Interaction, very good. And
hobby,
very good. In fact, I had written it in fine letters. I'll talk about hobby today. And
reading,
swimming. See, answers are not coming, which means you're so stressed, you're thinking. Sleeping,
meditation.
Entertainment, meditation, and
yoga.
Exercise. Yoga. Visualization.
Prayer.
Very good.
Attending your meetings.
Attending meetings.
Fighting with others. Speaking to a friend. Fighting with others.
Speaking.
Fighting with others.
Fighting. Okay, I'll write fighting here.
Spending some time with your spouse.
Spending time with spouse. Very good. And?
Family get together.
Family get together.
Helping your friend.
Helping friend. In fact, even I'm planning to start coming and, being one of the audiences very soon. Help library. Sorry? Traveling. So on and so forth. See, now you have opened up. You are enjoying it now. Yes?
Meeting and tech, talking with Derrick.
Oh, meeting. Thank you. Okay. Now let us see. Initially, we were either we were hesitating or we were thinking, what could be a stress reliever? My dear friends, there are more than hundreds and thousands of ways to convert your stress to energy. Now, what we apply is more important. Now, please keep your paper aside and your pen aside. I need your hands free now for 2 minutes. See, I'm showing you this. I'll tell you, my dear friends, I'm showing you all this so that it is not only that you're listening to me, you can go back home and help your friends, your family members or community members, whoever. There are many, many ways to find out whether you're stressed. So one is paper. I had paper. I carried the paper. I gave you. Now, let's imagine we don't have paper and you want to find out whether the person is stressed. Let's go like this. Our hands are free?
Yes.
Very good. Now, sit comfortable, all of you. Be comfortable. And just follow my instructions, okay? Watch your own breathing pattern. Observe your breath. Breathe consciously for some time. Now place your left hand on your chest and your right hand on your stomach. Keep it lightly, both your hands. Keep it light. And still concentrate on your breathing and slowly close your eyes. Watch your breath with your eyes closed. Breathe consciously. Keep your hands lightly on your chest and your stomach. And now, just feel which hand is moving more. Either your left hand will be moving up and down, or your hand on the stomach will be moving up and down more. One of the hand will be moving more than the other. Just realize it, just feel it. And very slowly open your eyes. Take your time. Fine. Now, how many of you felt that your left hand was moving more than the right hand? Put your hands up properly, please. Very good. Now, the other's right hand was moving more, correct? Good.
Both.
Well balanced. Very good. Okay. Now what happens is, my dear friends, when we are breathing, the reason I told you place your hand so that you have a judgment which hand is moving, so that you actually understand whether your chest is moving more or your stomach is moving more. When you are breathing and you breathe up to your chest, where your chest is moving in and out, which means your stress level is high. You are under stress. Now think of your score and think of your hand movement. Is it matching? Think about it. Matching, sir? Now, what happens is, when my stomach is moving more, it means my stress level is less. Why and how? Let's understand. May I rub the board?
Yes.
You'll remember all this, no?
Yes. Good.
I will not repeat all the terms from the beginning. Excuse my drawing. Now, when we are breathing, my dear friends, what's happening is, this is our chest level, right? When we are breathing up to our chest level, the oxygen comes here and moves out again. So, understanding that energy is moving, the energy is in a high content covering a short distance, which means energy is still present, waiting to be utilized, and it is not happening. This is a short turn that the energy, the breath is taken and the energy utilized. Similarly, if we train ourselves, it is not a big thing, matter of few minutes, breathing the correct way, we breathe, letting the air, the oxygen, pass through the stomach and out. What has happened? Distance covered is? Energy utilized is? Stress is energy, correct?
Can I be able to understand that the breathing is up to the stomach? How do I understand?
With your breathing pattern, which we'll just come to now. Now, when we are breathing, as I said, when your chest is moving more, it is understood that your breathing pattern, you are taking short breaths. You're taking short breaths. The oxygen is no doubt traveling throughout your body, but it should be traveling more consciously. Your lungs are underutilized. If you go and check it out, doctor will tell you, you are not utilizing 10% of your lung, 5% of your lung, 15% of your lung. That means you're not taking deep breaths. Deep breath is when your stomach starts moving. That is your deep and proper breath. So when the breath is traveling down up to your stomach, the utilization, understand, this is a very simple thing I'm talking to you. I'm not going to deep funda science out here. Very simple. Obviously, when it's traveling more, energy utilizes more. Energy utilizes more, what happens? There is no stagnation of energy. When there is no stagnation of energy, stress level comes down. You can try it right now. What you do is, put your hand on the stomach, and when you breathe in, keep your chin straight. This is a pattern. If you're breathing wrong, keep your chin straight, parallel to the floor. Look straight, put your hand on the stomach, and when you're breathing in, your stomach should come out. And when you breathe out, your stomach should go in. Just do it 7-8 times and see how you're feeling. There's no big science in this. Consciously do it. The chest should not be moving. Your stomach should be moving. When your chest moves, it is understood, yet it is going halfway. This takes some time, a few minutes to master it. It's okay, but just consciously try it. done. Do you feel any difference? Okay. Can you think of something stressful at this point of time? Can you think of something stressful? Okay. Now, can you imagine something stressful?
If there are no thoughts doing.
Exactly. At this point of time, what happens is when you're breathing consciously, with, I would say rather with your stomach, just take, speaking in plain language. Let me take an example. Suppose my boss has called me and I've done something wrong, or he is shouting at me and my colleague tells me, Derrick, your band is buzz out today. Go, boss is calling in the cabin. First thing is my heart will start thumping. I feel band buzz ke. I can listen to the band first only. So what I do is, I consciously breathe, understanding that my stomach is going out when I'm breathing. As I'm walking to his cabin, now here, understanding we have no time in hand. We are busy people. We are big people. We are busy. I have to walk from here to there to my boss's cabin. What do I do? Nothing. Trust me, even if I'm walking and breathing deliberately, my full stress is gone to almost zero. Try it out. Right now, you want to think of any stressful event of your life, or you want to think that gives you a stress, and think from your and breathe that way. Just try it out. You'll immediately feel you're trying to think. It's not coming 100%. You'll feel relaxed. Try it out. I'll come to that, sir. Detail I'll come later. That's why I don't. Yeah. Yes, sir. Please share. Would you like to share? No. Fine. One minute, sir. I agree. I know you people are the member of the library here. There are many shows, talk programs happening here. Now, what did I speak in the beginning was, most of us know everything, or most of us knows most of the things. But the question here is, now, as you put so many words on the board, walking, cycling, we all know. The question is, how many of us are doing is a question. The question is, how many of us are doing? The question is not whether you know or you do not know. That is not the question. Everybody knows everything, or at least something out of everything. But the question here is application. Are we applying or not? We all are here to get somewhere closer to something better every time. Every time there's a program here, somebody, the programmer, whoever comes with only one thought. Not that he will come here and talk and, like, you know, take the claps and go home. He's not looking at that. I don't think any programmer would be looking out for that. The idea of the programmer coming here to this specific place is to help the people who are sitting here and go home. So whenever he or she comes with something in mind that I will do my best to give something better than what is available so that the people benefit. Here, yoga is thousands of years old, Reiki is thousands of years old, everything is thousands of years old. I'm the new person here. But we are trying to get something closer to our daily life for our application. Nothing to teach anything to anybody. Application, important. Yes, ma'am, we just tried you. Would you like to share? No thoughts. Exactly. No thoughts. Application. It is a simple matter of application. Now, this is the fastest thing I showed you. The fastest, one of the fastest and one of the quickest. Second, you could say is your mudra. You join your these two classical mudra, the signature mudra, I would say.
Gyan mudra.
And it takes 3 minutes to 5 minutes, and you're whole normal. Yes, it's a fact. You get normal within 3 to 5 minutes, your whole system is normal. Very good. Now, our thing is, our question is, our question to ourselves is, how much of time am I going to invest in my program, my own program? Some busy person will say, I have only a few seconds, only 30 seconds. Tell me, Derrick, fast. I say, come on, sir, breathe from your stomach and go. Your job is done. Somebody will say, okay, I've got 5 minutes. I'll say, okay, do the mudra. Somebody will say, I've got 30 minutes. I'll say, good, go for a walk. So on and so forth. That is why I said, the more you interact with me today, the more applications we can see, and you can apply what you want to apply in your daily life. Applications are from seconds to hours. What you want to apply. Now, we all are traveling. Every day we travel somewhere or the other, maybe by train, maybe by bus, maybe by car. Let's assume I'm traveling by train. What am I doing? Okay, there are times when I don't get to sit. So I'm standing and doing what? I'm getting hyper. I'm abusing the government first. I'm going in the train and I'm abusing the government first. Then I'm abusing the population. Government is doing nothing. I would say, what are you doing? The government has to do nothing in this. So here, what am I doing? I'm ready to play all the blame games. Because of that, I am standing here. I was ready going by taxi. My wife said, no going by taxi. Bachao paisa. Go by train. And I'm standing here with everybody pushing me. Okay, fine. So what am I going to do? I have two choice. Get hyper, which we do. Second, okay, fine. I don't have music with me. I don't have any earphones with me.